Assalamualaikum. I'm Asad Yusuf and welcome to MPT channel. Today we're going to talk about which algorithm related parameter might influence the dose calculation accuracy. The things which I've studied in the last clinical training variant training in meningitis. So I'm sharing the slides. The parameter affecting small tree calculation and eclipse, there are mainly two parameters affecting dose calculation. Dosimetric leaf gap works on LLC output of small fields. The effective spot size work on the radiation source output of small fields and the number of small field size. So DLG affects the output, depend on output, and the spot size which we placed in administration during the commissioning, beam commissioning, and it affects the output and the number of. And these are the mainly two parameters which influence SRT planning. So the multi-leaf collimator, we need to understand about MLCs for the DLG. Of course, the Elekta has different system and the variant has different systems. So one has to be aware during the commissioning. The penumbra both along the cross MLC leaf could be defined as it depends on the leaf design and the position of the tech. So these round and penumbra is quite constant as a function of leaf position that we usually use dynamically. And the effects of turn and groove minimize the interleaf leakage, but penumbra on the sides are not identical. So the true beam collimation device, we have MLC 120 or HD MLC 120. They both have a different radius leaf and curvature, and one need to know. Halcyon has a different system. I'm not going to talk much about the Halcyon right now. So leaf transmission has to be evaluated for both bank A and B. Attention, each leaf could have its own transmission. So 5 to 10 millimeter have presumably different transmission. Point measurement, use a detector volume to indicate the reading and average out for the transmission. Off-axis transmission, reduction in transmission intensity mainly due to and change in off-axis beam spectrum. The end of the MLC leaves are rounded, so better off-axis to the metric statistics. Some variation passes between completely closed leaf here, rounded leaf, and influence delivery algorithm model the round leaf transmission with the dosimetric leaf gap. The algorithm takes round leaf transmission into a cone by shifting the leaf tip back by half of the value of the dosimetric leaf gap. The position in actual fluence spectrum. The gap between the fully closed leaf pair equals the dosimetric leaf gap value. And there is a description with the diagram. So these are the formulas which we usually use to calculate the dosimetric leaf gap. Those who are using variant machines, they are quite aware. Another parameter which affects the small field is effective spot size. So effective target spot size is mentioned in two directions during administration, X and Y. And as per recommendations, we usually write for AAA 1 mm and 0 for the Y direction as an accuracy. It's around 1.5 and 0. So these are the for the MLCs. We are defined with the MLC or we usually define with the JAWS. And so these are done by putting the different spot size parameter. And these are the results of the studies. You can go through and read the paper. Again, these are the results. And remember, the old version of Eclipse has a different values as compared to the new version. The MLC design same, but the integrity of the MLCs are different from the old version of these. And these are factors. So variance are just recommend in case of jaw setting and in case of anesthesia setting. So it depends on the clinic which setting they are prepared to use, whether they are going with the jaw setting or whether they are going with anesthesia setting. And these are the fluent map of the factor spot size and the results of the accuracy AAA. The increased spot size, blur dose, and modulation loss. DLG is specifically for the anesthesia, but the effective supplies can be for both dolls and for the anesthesia. And these are the results for the DLGs. The increased DLG reduced dose blurring and modulation required. So these are two parameters that play around for the small field. So what's the clinical impact? Does this whole long story about effective spot size and losing metric unique gaps have a clinical impact? Let's make an example. An acoustic neuroma, three partial arcs we met, triple echo calculation on true beam with HDMLC configured. And these are the values. For the measurements and calculations. So DLG 4 mm, where the spot size is fixed, and we are varying the DLG. So these are the results. So the mid one is 0.4, this is 1 mm, and this is 0.1 mm. This, you can see how the coverage effect of the DLG and the spot size change. Now the DLG remains same and the spot size are varying. These are the results. So last point to remember, we have seen variation of dose distribution when varying DLG and spot size. DLG and spot size are the parameter considered in AAA and accuracy algorithm. None of those is an actual PO computation. So remember, the optimization is not incorporating these parameters. Now those calculation in the end incorporated. So if you are running PO and then we run intermediate dose, then they may incorporate, depending on what algorithm you have chosen for the dose, they may incorporate intermediate dose, but for the actual fluence, it will not incorporate. This means that optimizer does not account the DLG and not optimize. The effect is only in the final dose. So the physics of the small field is not only a physics of problems, so these are the incidents of small fields, so one has to be aware how they use these small designs. So that's it. Thank you very much for the listening. I'm signing off.